Happy Tuesday, everyone. It's your favorite optometrist, Dr. Daryl Glover. And today we have a very, very special show in store for you guys. We have a star in eye care, a man that has all the answers when it comes to luxury, amazing eyewear. And who else is better to have the man himself, Mr. Alessandro Barante. How are you doing today, sir?
Great, Daryl. Thank you for having me on your amazing show. And thank you for elevating me so much. Now, how do I stay up to par to your elevation?
For those that are watching, tonight is all about top five eyewear. You know, we launched this show last year during the early stages of COVID, and we had to bring it back because Alessandro just really has an amazing collection, and I really wanted to share it with you guys, but also I wanted to take this opportunity just to get to know him a little bit better and understand his journey, because he has done quite a bit in the eye care industry and really has changed the game for numerous companies, and now has really changed the game for Derrigo Rim as well. So today I'd like to jump into just your story, man. If you don't mind just giving us a background of who you are, how you fell in love with eye care, eyewear, and let's just take it back to the beginning, man, to the essence from day one, if you don't mind.
Wow. How many hours do we have? I'll give you the short version. You know, well, first of all, I'm a person of faith. I'm a father and a proud father of two beautiful kids. They're 25 and 23. They don't like when I call them kids because they're not kids anymore, right? But for us, they will always be our children, right? And I grew up in the optical industry. I am from Florence, Italy, and my father was an executive for Optio. And I like to say that I grew up on a floor factory playing with Mazzucchelli acetate instead of Lego, as most kids do, right? And I had the opportunity to work for Optio at the beginning of my career. I had the opportunity to work for Luxottica for 23 years of my career. It was an amazing experience, a great learning experience for me. I had a short working relationship with Marcolin for a year. And then 3 years ago, I joined Derrigo Rim and as a president and the CEO of Derrigo Rim for the North America subsidiary. So, you know, it's a can I say over 30 years of career? That makes me very old, right?
You're a young man. You're only, 32, right?
Yeah, 32.
Wow, man, that's pretty fascinating. I mean, you've really touched every major eyewear company out there that's a major player in the eye care industry. And I know along this journey, you've picked up so much. But, you know, it's one thing to, you know, be a part of these different organizations and learn within these organizations. But where did you learn to become a leader? Because it had to start prior to joining some of these companies that you just mentioned. Because looking at your track record, you've always been in leadership positions. So I would love to just touch on that, because there's a lot of my colleagues out there that want to sit in that seat that you're sitting in, that want to be a leader, that want to be a CEO, that wants to be a president. You know, where did you get this leadership skills from?
Well, I'm still learning, Daryl. I really believe that life is a journey of learning. My advice to people that they're listening is you have to be curious. You have to care for other people's success. And you really have to have a passion for developing other people to succeed, for you to succeed. And you cannot be afraid of hiring people better than you. And there are many things that I don't know how to do. And I'll give you an example. If you give me an Excel file, I will not know where to start. But I have great people that work for me. They have great Excel skill set. And I have other skill set. And I focus on my strength. And I try to constantly develop my weaknesses. So as a leader, you have to surround yourself with great people. For me, it's been a little bit easier because I started from the bottom, and I did every single job that you can imagine in the industry when it comes to the supplier side of the industry. And so I'm not afraid of getting my hands dirty. So when I talk to people, I always say, I will never ask you to do something that I haven't done myself or I'm willing to do myself, right? And people love that. They love to be led by somebody that actually has done it before them, because, you know, it's like reading a great book, right? Why would you reinvent a great book when you can actually read it and follow the step of success of what it's in the book? You know, it's as simple as that.
Yeah, no, I love that. And that's one of the things that I always tell my team members in my office. You know, I started in the eye care industry selling glasses. Then I became an optometric technician. Then I became an assistant manager. And then I became an optometrist. And I've worked every position within the office, so I know what they're capable of doing and what they're not capable of doing. So I can understand and have that conversation with them one-on-one and give my stories of when I was a tech and how I did things and just let them know that I'm with you. And I would never ask you to do anything that I would never do. And I think, you know, this story that we're talking about right now really resonated with a lot of my colleagues that are optometrists over the last year, especially with COVID-19. Because a lot of us had to be the only person in the office during this time. So we had to become the person that was working up the patient, selling the glasses, answering the phone, cleaning the office. We had to be everything. And I hope that really resonated with my colleagues, because we have to appreciate our team members in our office and understand the value that they create for our day-to-day activities and for our patients that are there as well. So I really love that you touched on that.
No, thank you. We have a connection. And I think because of what happened in 2020, we're better today. You know, we survived that. We got stronger and we learned a new skill set, and we're better people today to what we used to be 1 year ago.
Yeah. And then speaking of COVID, you know, 2020, I mean, it's supposed to be the year of vision. And in a way, I still do think it was the year of vision, because it really changed the behavior and the mindset as eye care professionals, or, you know, companies, eyewear companies, and how we do business. You know, what was some of the major take homes that you guys took from 2020 in regards to how you do business? Because everyone was impacted, and I know you guys are in a better, stronger position now, but what are some of the things that you guys did?
Well, you know, I think we used to take a lot of things for granted in the past. Okay. And you know, I learned to really look at things in a different way and to have a different appreciation for everything. On our side, I can tell you that we really focus on our customers. We really focus on the needs of our customers. We try to put ourselves in their shoes, and we completely switched from a sales approach to an helping approach in starting in March of last year, and we kept that mindset throughout the entire period of the pandemic, and even now we're not going to change that. I mean, it's really having the customer centric approach in a meaningful way, not just the beauty of the word that it sounds good, right? Everybody likes to say I'm customer centric, but what that really means that you really need to care about others and really look at the business as a consultant, and trying to bring value to your customers in different form. We develop a business collaboration with no financial interest for the RegoRAM, but with all of a business perspective for our customers, to help them remodel, to help them navigate in visual managed care, to help them communicate with the social media. And you know, to help them build in a B2B or a B2C platform to really expand their business. I mean, things that we never done before, and that was an opportunity to focus on these and to focus on education as well.
Wow, that's fantastic. So I like that. You guys really are taking more of a holistic approach of business. You know, you're helping with amazing product. Then you're also helping, you know, with social media, the marketing, POP, just taking a different approach, making sure that your team members are well educated to educate on how to sell the product, but also how to navigate through the tough terrain of insurance and all that other jazz. That is fantastic.
Thank you. Thank you, Daron. There is an incredible tool on my website, which is called the Resource Center. It's on the top left of the website. And when you click on the Resource Center, it's all about that. Resources on how to strive with my business, being an independent practitioner. So I suggest the audience to click on that button and really explore all of these free assets that we post in there.
Fantastic, fantastic. You guys check it out so you can get all that information. Now, Darigo, REM.
Yeah.
Why? Why did you choose to go with that company to lead? I mean, outside of the fabulous eyewear, you know, what made you want to jump into to this position? Because I'm a firm believer that, number one, before you can make any decision in life, you, like you mentioned earlier, you got to have faith. I'm a big man of faith. There's no doubt about that. So I, that's why I know we gel and we click extremely well here. But number two, you have to know your purpose and your why, and you got to make sure that that purpose and that why and your core values align with the company that you're trying to do business with or work for or lead. So, you know, I would love to know just what really made you want to go into that direction, because with your background, you could really go to any company that you want. But why did you choose this one as the company to lead?
Well, I have to tell you, Daryl, thank you for the question. It's a great question. Is leaving Luxottica for me was the most difficult decision that I had made in my professional career, because I had an amazing career. I had no reason to leave. And I have all kinds of opportunity that I was ready to explore. And I learned so much from it. So I'm so grateful to my experience with Luxottica. But I was ready for something else. You know, I believe that in life you prepare both personally and professionally for the next journey that you are facing. It can be the journey to become a father, right? And everybody can be a great father, but not everybody can be a great parent. I think you have to be ready for that. You know, and the same thing is in business. You know, I was at a point where I had a great position. I had an elevated position in the company, but I was an implementer. I was not a decision maker. And with Darigo Rem, I had the opportunity to be the decision maker because I'm running the company and apply everything that I learned in my over 30 years of experience in the industry. So it was the time for me to do it because, you know, if I don't do it now, when am I going to do it? You know,
remember, you're only 32, right? So you have, right? So, you know, that's interesting, man, because a lot of folks are at that turning point, right? They're like, do I continue to stay within this organization and grow? Or is it time for me to make that jump to another organization? That's always a tough call. It's always tough to make that decision. And I feel like there's no right answer. I mean, you can pray about it and see where you're led to, but it's always difficult, man. So, you know, in the position that you were with Luxottica and where you are now, it's just, you know, I was mind blown. I was like, wow, that's a great place to be. And now you're here. But what made you even want to jump into that position? So, you know, thanks for sharing that with us.
Of course.
I would love to talk a little bit more before we jump into your top five eyewear, just about the brand a little more in detail, like maybe some of the different brands or licenses that you have in regards to Darigo Rem. So if you don't mind just sharing some of those amazing and spectacular brands that you guys have, that's a part of your portfolio.
Oh, thank you. It's a great company because Darigo, the Italian company behind the scene, acquired Rem in 2016. Both independent family company with incredible family value. And Darigo has an incredible history of manufacturing eyewear. We're actually known in Italy for the standard of manufacturing of luxury and ultra-luxury product. And not only we produce our own product, but you will be surprised to the product that we produce, which I cannot mention in public, but very, very high-end names. And so the top of the line in our portfolio is Chopard, which is it's in the ultra luxury segment. It's a jewelry collection, and just in a few months from now, we're actually launching Philippe Plein, which is another incredible, incredible European designer. So we're very excited. I had the opportunity actually to communicate with Mr. Plein. You know, he wants to do an incredible event in California. He's building a huge chateau in Bel Air. And so I'm excited about this business relationship.
But when you go visit, Bring me along so I can hang out as well, okay?
Hey, when you come to LA, you're my guest.
All right, man. I love it. I'm going to do it.
And then, you know, from entry-level collection all the way to the ultra-luxury, we have everything in between. This year in particular, we just launched an incredible collection in January. We launched a Diff Eyewear, which is a huge collection, especially on social media. We're launching Tumi Eyewear in June.
Tumi?
The luggage company.
You're going to have to hold it down with the eyewear because my father, he travels quite a bit all across the world, and the first time I came across Tumi was him, and we were sitting down, we were having a conversation, and I was like, Tumi, what is this? And then he told me about it, and I started touching it and moving it around, and I was like, this is good quality stuff. So this is going to be great with Tumi as far as eyewear.
Oh yeah, you're going to see the quality of the luggage in the eyewear. Everything is going to be made in Japan. We're going to have wearable technology as well.
Oh, nice.
Carbon fiber, aluminum, and the collection is going to be incredible. And then we just launched Lotz Eyewear, which is the oldest brand in the optical industry, 1867, and it's an historical brand from Italy, and we're launching a Scada, and then in our current portfolio, we have so many lines, and I want to make sure I remember all of that, from Jones New York to Lucky Brand, to Carolina Herrera, to John Varvatos, of course, and the Police Eyewear.
Oh, and, Police is doing some big stuff. Who's the representative or your ambassador for Police? You guys have a pretty big name, right?
He's an amazing guy. He's Lewis Hamilton, which is the six-time champion of the world of the Formula One, racing for the Mercedes Pennzoil team. So an incredible, incredible guy. And he has a personal collection of over 1,000 eyewear. And he's directly involved in the design of the product. He's actually directly involved with that. And it's really, for him, eyewear is like the ultimate fashion accessory. Yeah.
Yeah, we got to get him on the show too there. We got to see that collection. That's a lot.
We should.
Well, that's fantastic, man. An amazing collection, high-end luxury brands. You're growing. This is fantastic. Well, you know, everyone came out this evening to learn more about your eyewear, your top. So I want to dive deep into that. It doesn't have to be in any order, but let's take it from the top. If you don't mind sharing with us your first piece up.
Well, before I do, I want to share a story. So
yeah.
I have a display of eyewear just outside of my bedroom. And every day when I get dressed, I go to the display and I pick the eyewear that coordinates with my outfit and also with my mood, you know. And I choose the eyewear for the day based on the activity they're going to do during the day. And in many cases, I leave my house with two pair of eyewear. And I have my pouch, which is a John Varvatos pouch that I use, and I put my eyewear in the pouch, and I carry them in my briefcase along with my cleaning cloth. And often during the day, I change my eyewear and based on the meeting that I'm going to attend. And especially today, they were also present on social media and different platform. Eyewear today is becoming even more of a relevant accessory, right? Because, I mean, look, we can be having this call and you don't know if I'm wearing pants, right? You know that I'm wearing eyewear.
That's for sure, man. That's for sure. You know, I love that, man. I'm the same way. But when I get dressed in the morning, the first thing I think about are definitely my glasses. And whatever these are, I dress myself down. And I've been that way for who knows how long. And I'm a firm believer that, you know, eyewear really reflects your personality and it radiates the type of energy that you're going to put out in the world that day as well. So we're here on that. We're connected on that one, man. I love it.
Well, I will say that my favorite eyewear currently is my Police by Lewis Hamilton. It's actually the frame that I'm wearing, which is an incredible frame because it's a Mazzucchelli 529, which is a biodegradable material. This frame is 100% biodegradable, so it's all about sustainability. And even the lenses, as you can see, I have the engraving of Lewis Hamilton on the lenses, yes, on the top left over there. And I like this acetate frame because of the comfort and the comfort and the design. I love this transparent tempo. You can actually see all of the construction of the frame. And I love it so much that I have actually multiple colors. So, and I want you to see the difference as I'm wearing this frame in this, definitely this is a statement piece, right? In terms, yeah, of colors and in terms of even the boldness of the frame, right? Now, I have the same frame in, look how beautiful is this crystal over here.
Oh, wow.
It's exactly the same frame, but look at the effect. It's a completely different effect, right? So, yeah, if I want to present myself in a meeting and I don't want to dominate the meeting and I want to give attention to others, I'm going to wear this type of look, which is a little bit more subtle, right?
Right.
But at the same time, if I want to make a statement and I want people to pay attention to what I'm saying,
sure,
I'm gonna go with this power piece, like the one that you're wearing. You know, I'm, yeah, paying attention to you. You got a power piece on. You know, you're demanding for my attention, right?
And hey, I know I was gonna be on the live today with the man himself, so I had to come right. So I had to bold and powerful, so I can stand up as well, you know.
Oh, I love that. And lenses are very important for me. I put transition lenses in all of my eyewear, and I also do a nice AR coating. I have a little bit of a tint. You can see a little bit of a blue coloration on it. I love that.
You know, I'm glad that you brought that up because, you know, some frame guys do not really understand. I'm not going to say they don't understand the importance of the lens technology, but that is a huge piece. And as eye care professionals, I personally feel like we should always lead with the conversation with lens and then the frame, because the lens is what's going to allow the person to see. And it's that function piece. But then we always have that fashion piece, the retail piece of the frame, and we create that perfect marriage between the two. But that's music to my ears, just hearing you talk about, you know, the coatings, the transitions, you know, that acetate, or excuse me, the transparent pair that you have, having that with, yeah, a nice transitions style color will really make that frame go to the next level. You're talking about different looks, just,
oh, yeah,
one frame and different colors of transitions can really go to the next level. So that's fantastic, man.
And of course, you know, transition is not a substitute for sunglasses. So I, yeah, have my prescription sunglasses that I wear every single day. I have many of them.
Yeah.
This is a John Varvatos. This is an artisan collection.
Oh, wow.
It's a limited edition, one off of 300 made in the world. And it's an annual collection that we launch in John Varvatos. It's called the Artisan Collection Limited Edition.
Very nice.
And this is my prescription sunglasses. And I love it because I can be at the pool and I can read my newspaper. And, you know, and it gives me the comfort and the protection that I need against the UV rays and all of that, right?
So, looking quite handsome and stunning in those as well, man. That's a good look. I really like the detail on the temples. It seemed like it was some texture or layered or something going on there on the temple, which is pretty
cool. It's ebony wood.
Okay.
And then you have a mother of pearl kind of treatment on it. So it's beautiful. Beautiful. So
this collection that you're talking about, does John Varvatos typically mix up different materials with that to just make it really stand out a tad bit more? Or if you can give us a little history or education about that, because this is my first time hearing about this. So this is a fantastic piece to talk to, you know, those eyewear connoisseurs that come in and drop thousands of dollars a year on glasses.
Yeah, actually, every time that we release product, we post a video on our resource center under the brand training that explains the feature and benefit of the entire collection. So there is beautiful video about the artisan. The 2020 collection was a collaboration with John Varvatos and Gibson Guitar. And so you see in the eyewear a lot of key component of the guitar. And it can be little details and can be the rivet. It can be the construction of the frame. It can also be the coloration of the acetate that is matching limited edition colors of the Gibson guitar. The 2021 collection, which is going to be released in September, is going to be all about leather. the application of leather in eyewear. It's gonna be a story of a leather application, and it's okay. gonna be breathtaking. We're gonna unveil that at Vision Expo West in Las Vegas.
Okay, all right, I'll be there.
And then my other frame. This is a Chopard. I love this frame because it's a metal frame, and of course, all of my frame they have to have enough room for my progressive lenses because I'm not 32, I'm over 50 there. So I need those progressive lenses. Now, this frame in particular, I love it because the top part of the frame is made from a volcanic stone. And then the temple, it's a three-dimensional temple that has a wood insert and carbon fiber insert on the three-dimensional temple. So yeah. It's an incredible frame. It's very lightweight. It's very elegant. And this is my dressy frame. When I wear a suit with a tie, I like to put this frame on because it gives me a little bit more of an edge about luxury, and it makes me look more classy than more of a conventional pair.
Sure, sure.
And then I also wanted to show you something very personal to me. This is my pajama eyewear. I don't know if you have a pajama eyewear. My pajama eyewear is the frame that I wear in my house when I want to feel comfortable. That is not necessarily something that I'm going to wear in public. And it's beautiful to me. You may not like it, but it's beautiful to me. It's very comfortable. I follow to sleep with my pajama eyewear when I read in my bedroom. And I don't care because it can help. It can hold any type of abuse. And are you ready for my pajama?
Bro, boom, 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 boom.
Here we go. How do you like it?
Man, those are jazzy. Those that needs to go past the bedroom. That needs to go into public.
But see, it's a little crooked because I follow to sleep in it. You know what I mean? So
we can find a master optician to adjust those for you. I'm pretty sure. But you know, it's funny you mentioned that. I actually have my bedroom eyewear as well. So
let me see.
They're actually my computer glasses, and this is what I wear whenever I'm reading my iPad, tablet, or whatever. And these are kind of back as well. And I have this one actually in multiple colors, multiple flavors, but this is the one that I typically wear whenever I'm laying in the bed also. So, and I have a 3-year-old. So, you know, he wants to be like daddy, so he wants to take daddy's glasses. Oh. Put them on and all that other jazz as well. So I can't walk around the house with these because they'll be damaged or my other eyewear. But that's the thing. I think everyone has a pair of bedroom or home glasses that they actually wear. And you're the first one to ever bring that up on the show, man. So
my pajama eyewear, right?
You're starting something new. That's going to be the next question I ask the next person on. Let me see your pajama eyewear. Throw them Well, man, that was a fantastic collection. Great options, great lens options. Love that each piece really had amazing architecture on it. You could just see all the details that made the frame look a little more rich and make it pop more. For any occasion, you can clearly tell you have the right frame for. And that's fantastic, man, because, you know, glasses can really reflect our personality. And it can also change who we are depending on the day. So that's fantastic that you've really been able to capture that. And being, you know, head over at that organization, you wear glasses every day because that truly shows your team that you believe in the brand, you believe in equality, and you are, you know, practicing what you preach day in and day out. So fantastic work.
Thank you, Daryl. Thank you very much.
So what's next, man? What's next for DeRigo Rim? What's on your agenda for 2021? I mean, I know you guys have really changed the game over the last year with, you know, more education on the website, things you're doing with your agents, how you're communicating with insurance companies and things of that nature. But what's for 2021? What do you guys have in store?
Well, we have a great expectation for 2021, and it cannot be any worse than 2020 in terms of business, right? So we can only go up, but that's the good news, right? So I think everybody's going to experience growth in 2021. If you don't, you're in trouble. And for us it's about expansion. You know, we've been building the base of our business since the acquisition in 2016. In my last 3 years, I really developed the infrastructure now to really take the company to the next level. We're actually adding 20 new business professional position in United States, and as we're launching six new brands in 2021. So the company is going to expand dramatically, and we have incredible program. We're very much closer to our customers. We know their needs, and we try to listen as much as we can, and we are very agile, we're very fast. So that means that we can customize a program and change direction very fast if something doesn't work. And I think is one of the main advantage of our company.
Fantastic. Well, it seems like you guys have it going on. You have a vision, you have a plan. It makes sense because you guys clearly have a fierce leader. I'm looking forward to seeing what you guys have going moving forward and, 5-10 years down the road. And, Alessandro, I just want to thank you dearly for taking the time to hang out with me this evening. I've been watching you on social media for who knows how long, especially on LinkedIn, and you've done an incredible job with just leading the team over there and really just putting iCare on the map. So continue the great work, man, and I hope to grow with you as time goes by. And if there's anything that the Defocus Media family can do, you let us know. We're there. And I'm going to hold you to that trip when I come to L.A., man, because I love L.A. I love the culture. I love the vibe. I'm ready to come out there and party with you, my man. And you got to party like you're 32, not 52, all right?
Let's do it, Daryl. It was a pleasure. God bless you, man. And I love your show. I love everything you do for the industry. Keep up the great work for everybody. We need that positive infusion of positivity, you know, to keep going in these hard times.
Well, thank you so much, man. It's your favorite optometrist, Dr. Daryl Glover. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in this evening. You guys stay healthy, positive, and blessed. Until next time, you guys have a great one. Talk to you later.